answer is, I have several parts of the answer. First of all, my research was not about, I mean, somehow, but I didn't do a history of indigenous movement as such. So it's not really my area. But it might be also connected to, you know, neoliberalism. But you have always also to contextualize it. Now, I disagree with you that the main thing that indigenous people receive is right of consultation. I think it's a part that you didn't have time to get into. I think that the major part is their right to land, territories, and so on. And this is becoming, according to my analysis, is becoming part of customary international law. So this is quite serious, and it has not in only theoretical issues, but also actual repercussions in courts, in regional courts, in local courts in some areas. So actually, it has some power. It's not only now so the issue of distributive justice. So in the Israeli context, we show, first of all, this is not the only argument. The argument are that if you, for example, take concept of human dignity, if you take concept of property and so on, and distributive justice, the Bedouins, even without recognizing any rights, just as being citizens, and comparing, for example, how much land they have compared to Jewish settlements in the Negev, for example, they should, even if they get all their claiming, they're still lacking in comparison to land allocated for free, essentially, to kibbutzim, to moshavim, to things like that. So I'm really thinking much more strategically than, I don't see these things as essentialist, but, and here I return to the issue that in the Israeli context, my understanding that they have there's almost no alternative that either clinging to the land or trying to internationalize the discourse. And if you want to do it, you have to use an international law. I mean, it's very helpful to use international law language. So, because anything that cannot have, they are isolated even within the Palestinian society, certainly they cannot have things that happen in other areas to have cross groups, coalitions. The Israeli legal system is really, as I said, they have no way to. I mean, we conclude the book. We have the last part of the conclusion. We analyze the latest Supreme Court, but now President of the Israeli Supreme Court, Ayub. And this is essentially a case that she's very smart, but essentially says to the Bedouin, "Don't bother us anymore. We don't want to hear about you. Go away, and you have nothing to come to us." Essentially, so it's essentially this issue. Now, the last answer is that, of course, there are many prices. One of the prices, and we're missing Rawia here. Rawia would have brought the feminist perspective: what it is to be a minority within a minority, what is it to be a Bedouin woman in a polygamous society, and so on. So there are many complicated issues that, I don't want to portray it as something very bright, but I think it's a tool.